In today's devlog, we're taking a look at some changes made to our wave system and weapons. What's different? Well, stay put to find out. Hi, I'm Jonas. Welcome to another video. In this devlog series, I talk about an upcoming roguelike game set in the nightmares of the pyjamas-wearing boy, Billy. So, if you're new here, consider subscribing. Like I said before, we have now made some changes to our wave system and weapons, and I'm really excited to show you what we have done with the weapons, so make sure to stay till the end of the video. First, I wanna show you what we have done with the wave system and why we decided to change it in the first place. Before, when you entered a room in the nightmare, enemies would already be waiting for you inside. And when you kill them, red circles would appear on random positions in the room, spawning more enemies. We felt that this looked a bit weird and boring, so we decided to spawn our enemies from some kind of portal instead. I began working with a very simple placeholder for the portal, but it wouldn't take very long time before Fabian made a much better portal. This one even had a cool animation where the portal rises from the ground. At first, the room would spawn one of these portals per wave, with only one enemy spawning every second. But this made the game way too easy, with all enemies marching at you in a straight line from the same place. So I added another portal and made the enemies spawn randomly between them. In the bigger rooms, two portals still wasn't enough. So I added some code which spawned different amounts of portals based on the room size. The portals would also stay in the room during the whole wave. I thought that this would look cool, but it turned out to be pretty bad game design, because the big portals took up so much space in the room, and you couldn't see what was going on behind them. There was also a risk that enemies would spawn from a nearby portal without warning and damage the player. So, to solve these problems, I made the portals move back into the ground after all enemies had spawned. And to make sure that the portals were up for the same amount of time, I made all enemies spawn over a set time instead of once per second like before. And to make it more clear how many waves you have to complete, I added some text at the top of the screen. And I also added some text which tells you how many enemies you have to kill on the current wave. Lastly, I made it so that the waves spawn more difficult enemies after each room you clear. So now, the first room you enter won't spawn the most dangerous enemies at once, like it was before. Another thing we have added related to the combat is floating damage text on the enemies. Why did we decide to add damage text? Well, our standard enemies used to have only 3 HP, with the player dealing 1 damage per projectile. This made it very difficult for us to add different kinds of weapons, when a projectile always removes a third of an enemy's health. So, to make it easier to add more weapon variation, we increased the enemy's health from 3 to 100. And to make it clear that the weapons had different damage ranges, we decided to add floating damage text to show you the numbers. I also made it possible for your attacks to land a critical strike, which deals double damage. This made combat much more interesting. Now that our game had critical strikes, we thought that perhaps our weapon should have different chances to land a critical strike. One thing led to another, and we decided to give our weapons a big makeover. Before, the only information you could see about the weapon was its name. Now, you can also see its damage, crit chance, fire rate, and knockback. So now, you don't have to buy the weapon to find out how good or bad it is. The weapons now also have a chance to get a random prefix, which affects their stats in different ways. It can be small changes like increasing the knockback of your projectiles, or more dramatic changes like making your weapon insanely fast. With these newly added prefixes, we can now give our weapons more variation without having to create hundreds of different weapons. Now that our weapons could have different stats, it felt obvious to add a way for the player to change the stats of his weapons. So, we decided to add a character to the Tooth Fairy's shop, who can reforge your weapons. We thought it would be fun if the character was one of Santa's elves. So, we added one of the elves from our first game, Christmas Quest. Of course, your weapons doesn't always get better when reforging. Sometimes, you get new stats that makes your weapon useless, so it's a bit of a gamble. Your starting weapon can't be reforged at all, because it would totally ruin the balance of the game if your tiny starting weapon with unlimited ammo would become too overpowered. With different stats and a way for the player to change them, our weapons have now become much more interesting. The only thing remaining is to come up with other types of weapons to add to the game. Do you have any suggestions for funny weapons that Billy can use? Let me know down in the comments. This was everything I had to show you for this devlog. If you liked the video, make sure to leave a like, or leave a dislike if you didn't. And make sure to also subscribe to my channel, so you don't miss any upcoming devlogs. Thanks for watching, and remember, don't let your nightmares wake you up.